I'm looking forward to this.
I appreciate that.
I won't be able to sit at home.
You can always watch the recording. Some guys told me.
Thank you.
Microphone checker. Microphone checker. Microphone checker. Yo, yo, yo.
The final countdown before tip-off. Okay, welcome to the YouTube live stream of the Father Malley Invitational. If you're just joining us, this is the tournament, this is the game to determine third place. This is the consolation game, this is the desolation game. There are no fourth place trophies, no participation, it's third place or nothing. This is for all the marbles in the bag. We're tipping off here shortly. We want to thank our sponsors, the Knights of Columbus, who do wonderful things for your local church community and for seminarians and priests. We also want to thank Jesus Christ, who is our ultimate sponsor. Without him, nothing is possible. The way this game works, 12 people on the court. 5 people from one team, 5 people from another team, and 2 refs. They duke it out, and the team, generally speaking, at the end of the game, at the end of regulation, at the end of 2 halves, to have the most points will be the victors. Seems to be delaying the action. We will get back to you shortly. Everything is totally okay. Nothing to freak out about. And this is James Flattery, everybody. He's a good guy from Davenport, Iowa. He's sweeping the floor right now. Stand-up guy. And this is Nick Lee, Diocese of Atlanta. And he is the boss of the basketball tournament. He's a good dude. Pray for him. Everybody, this is Michael Bremer, reporter for the Mundelein Father O'Malley Invitational, and here we have Michael Rich Bremer. Rivera from the Great Diocese of Tucson. Rich, tell the people, what is the fundamental attitude and disposition that one must undertake in order to take on the game of basketball?
I want to win.
Okay, yes, exactly, a desire. Desire that flows from the heart to want to win. If you want to lose, what's the point of playing? There isn't one. Thank you. Thank you very much for those wise words of wisdom. Camera, back to you.
I find it analogous for the Christian life.
Amen. Amen to that. Your Christian life is like basketball. Rich Rivera from Tucson, everybody. Back up to you. That was good. That was very good. Yeah. You're natural.
No, I'm not that wrong.
Good point. Good point.
All right, YouTubers, if you're just joining us for today, this is the consolation, the desolation game for third place. The winner of this game will take home a trophy. The loser of this game will take home nothing. There is no participation prize here. All the marbles are on the table. All the marbles are in the bag. And here we go. We have 35 seconds before tip-off. Our Lady of Guadalupe Seminary, Bishop Simon Bruté Seminary, head-to-head, face-to-face, max velocity, strap up. This is going to be a ride of your life. Are excited and set to tip off. Here we go. Time to play some basketball. Lady Guadalupe's ball. Dribbling, passing. Patience. Wow. And PSP gets the rebound as they dribble west down the court. So I'm not sure if you can see it on YouTube, but Our Lady Guadalupe, they have three brothers, and they look eerily similar to each other. So just a shout out to their parents, three of the same siblings at the seminary. That's amazing. Thank you, parents, to them. And the first points are on the board. Bishop Simon Bruté 1, Our Lady Guadalupe Seminary 0. Free throw, second attempt is good. 2-0 here, just beginning the game. Dribbling, tries to make some room, passes, dribbling, shoots, and it's good! 3 points for OLG. Of his own. These don't cost anything because they're called free throws. He misses his first attempt. Second attempt underway. Some state names. He shoots. Close. No cigar. Wow. Good defense. Another turnover. Something happened there, now it's OLG's ball. Got a couple subs coming in. What happens with subs is normally the players are running back and forth so often that they get really tired. So newer, fresher players have to come in to relieve them. They take a rest, the other players get tired, and then subs will come in for them. It's a circle of basketball. Bishop Simon's ball. Still 3-2 here as we approach 13 minutes in the first half. That's the first half, one out of two halves. Bishop Simon worked their magic. Only time will tell. Pass the ball inbounds. Defense passes, dribbles. Out of bounds again. Punch defense. Passes. Passes. Turns over, traveling, and it's Bishop Simon's ball. It's two subs for Bishop Simon Bruté come in. Bishop Simon Bruté on the offense. Long shot. Come on, Isaac sweeps the floor. If you're just tuning in with us today, you're watching Our Lady of Guadalupe Seminary take on Bishop Simon Bruté Seminary in the third place consolation desolation match. Some staunch defense by Our Lady Guadalupe as Bishop Simon tries to get some offensive magic here. 11 minutes left to go in the first half as a sub comes in.
Who's got it? Who's the
first?
Timeout, White. And White takes a timeout. Under 11 minutes left to go in the first half. It's one of two halves. Only two halves here in basketball. Score is 3-2. Earlier we pointed out James Flattery, who is sweeping the floor over on the east side of the court. Here we have Isaac Doucette, who's sweeping the floor on the west side of the court. He's also from Davenport. So you could say Davenport is sweeping our floors this morning. We thank you, the Diocese of Davenport, for providing us wonderful seminarians. Isaac and James, wonderful guys. And it's time to start back up the action. The ref wants blue to stand right here.
Let's go! Black start!
Staunch defense by Our Lady Guadalupe as they head on the offensive. Shoots, no good. Rebound. Bruté on the offensive. OLG on the offensive. 10 minutes left to go here in the first half. Rebound by OLG as they dribble down the court. Dribbling, 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 passing.
41, set it up, 41.
That was a call for traveling. OLG's ball as they go on the offensive. Passes, dribbles, steal. His ball. Stop. So Bishop Simon Bruté Seminary hails from Indiana. Shout out to any fans of Bishop Simon Bruté Seminary. Shout out to all the parents of the seminarians watching this game. Without you and your love of your kid, none of this would be possible for him to be in formation for priesthood. Interesting fact about Simon William Gabriel Bruté de Vermeer. He was a French missionary in the United States and the first bishop of the Diocese of Vincennes, Indiana. John Quincy Adams called him the most learned man of his day in America. That was John Quincy Adams saying, the most learned man of his day in America was Bishop Simon Bruté. Interesting fact about Bishop Simon Bruté is he's not a saint yet. Looking for a miracle? Pray for his intercession. His cause is underway. Looking for some offensive magic here. Shoots it. Oh, so close. There's Simon Bruté on the retaliation. Looking to answer. Shoots. Short. Rebound by OLG. As they are back on offense. Timeout White. A little break in the action. Break is over, the teams are set back to match up again. 5 minutes, 34 seconds left to go here in the first half. OLG has the lead. Teams talk strategy during the break, and let's see if it pays off. Takes the first attempt. It's no good. Rebound, Bishop Simon Bruté. They advance down the court. Bishop Simon Bruté looking for some magic of their own on offense here. OLG with the turnover. They march down the court. Fast break, though. There you go. Passes. Inbounds. Turnover. New offensive strategy for OLG seems to be working. Will Simon Bruté be able to answer? Time will tell. 7-2 here in the first half, remaining minutes. And it's OLG's ball. It's a turnover out of bounds. OLG's ball. Dribbling, driving. Almost scoring. Gets the rebound and it's a score. Puts the board in for two. Simon Bruté, looking to answer. Call on OLG. One sub comes in for OLG, one player comes out. Time to rest up. OLG's ball. Widen their lead here on offense. Drive. Oh! That's a foul. Now 10-2 here with 2 minutes left to go. Blue timeout. The Diocese of Davenport hard at work sweeping our floors, making sure the players stay safe. Wiping away any debris, dust, or sweat that has fallen on the floor in this intense battle of basketball. Thank you, Diocese of Davenport. We want to thank our pre-theologians for working the scoreboard and the bookkeepers. Hello, pre-theologians. They will all be theologians one day. They're all good men. Actually, most of them are from the Diocese of Atlanta. Matt, you can join too. Exactly. Thank you, pre-theologians, for your fine work. It's Bruté's ball. Sweep everything up. Number one will take a shot or two for his free throw attempt. Scores 11-2 with a minute and a half left to play in the first half. Another foul. Second attempt here underway. I'm not sure if you can hear it on YouTube. There's an eerie silence every single time a person takes a free throw attempt. It requires the utmost concentration just for one simple point. Another foul. We'll take an attempt or two. You can literally hear a pin drop right now. On its feet. They are cheering loudly, wildly, crazily, intensely. And a foul.
Two.
OLG with the ball. Looking to widen their lead. OLG takes it, dribbles, drives. No, so close. Bruté on the offensive. OLG with the turnover. 30 seconds left to go here in the first half. The first of two halves. Ooh. So close. 15 seconds left to play here. As Bruté, will they be able to lessen the lead that OLG has against them? They look to drive down the court. There we have it, folks. That's the first half. Our Lady Guadalupe, 13. Bishop Simon Bruté, 5. And in this intense game. Okay, everybody. I don't know what it looks like on YouTube, but these teams have been taking a lot of shots. It's not too easy to get the ball inside the hoop. This is a regulation-sized ball. No, we are not sponsored by Wilson. We're not sponsored by Spalding. We're sponsored by, we just have these balls, the Evolution version. So this ball is about 9.55 inches in diameter. The hoop, the regulation-sized hoop over there, is about 10 feet tall and is about 18 inches in diameter. Meaning that this ball has to get inside that hoop. Now you can tell it's pretty well inflated, right? No deflated balls over here. Thank you, Patriots. And the point is to get this ball inside that hoop. But this is extremely difficult when you have five people closing in on you and you have to try and get it and concentrate and get it inside that hoop. It's amazing. And so because it's so well inflated, it'll bounce really easily. It bounces super easy. And the thing is, if it hits the rim in any sort of misappropriate way, it's just going to bounce right out. And it is incredibly difficult. On YouTube, NBA, it might look easy, but these players are struggling. It is an intense game of basketball. It is ferocious out here. And it is it's wild. The crowd is on its feet. They're cheering loudly. That's about it for halftime. We'll check back in again with you in about 2.5 minutes here as we start the second half. Both teams warm up right now, shooting some hoops, keeping their skills sharp. Forty-five seconds left here in this halftime break. Be sure to check out your local Knights of Columbus chapter. We want to give thanks to them being our sponsors. Also, today's Sunday, you should probably go to Mass too. I want to thank Jesus, who is our sponsor, always, and the Holy Spirit and God the Father. Give thanks and eternal praise to him. I just want to introduce you to Robbie Cotta over here. He's an archdiocesan of Atlanta seminarian, a real stand-up guy. Always has words of wisdom. Always a bright, shining face here in the morning.
It's great to be here with you all today.
Grin.
Sunday blessings to all the folks back home.
Hi, Mrs. Cotta. You're so awesome. Here we go. The action set to begin here in the second half. Our Lady of Guadalupe Seminary against Bruté Seminary. All the marbles in the bag here for third place. It's either desolation or consolation. It's either victory or loss. Who will win? Only time will tell. 18 minutes, fouls, shots, scores, falling on the ground, running, dribbling, passing, shooting. All of this goes into the variables of who will win this game at the end of regulation. Again, we have 12 people on the court, 5 on each team, 2 refs, a bunch of fans, 1 basketball, 1 prize, 1 victory, 1 third place for the 2018 here in the Father Pat O'Malley Tournament. So immediately you start to recognize the difference between both halves. This is perhaps one of the most confusing aspects about basketball. The very hoop Our Lady of Guadalupe was trying to score on, they're now defending. And the very hoop that Simon Bruté was trying to score on, they're defending. They switch halves. Now, Simon Bruté, they're going east. Our Lady of Guadalupe, they're going west. Our Lady of Guadalupe's ball. Here we go, on the offensive. They are moving west.
Yeah,
Interesting fact about basketball, it's called basketball because they used to shoot a ball inside of a basket. What families would do on the weekend, they would attend their local YMCA with a picnic. They would eat the meal, and then when the basket was empty, they'd tape it to the wall, and they would try and throw things inside of it. Of course, that's how the name basketball came about. Nowadays, we have to ask the question, is it still appropriate to call the game basketball when they have changed it into a net? It was a little bit difficult back in the day because baskets have bottoms. So anytime you shot whatever into the basket, you'd have to climb up a ladder, which is dangerous sometimes, and you'd have to take the thing out and then resume play. Here, they simply took the bottom out of the basket and changed the basket into a net. So again, we have to ask ourselves, would this game more appropriately be called hoop ball or net ball? I don't know. Take a vote, contact your local congressman, see if you can change. Thirteen to nine here, with 15 and a half minutes to go left in the second half. All the marbles, all the consolation, all the desolation. First attempt is good. They widen the gap. OLG up five. And now we have another ref who has checked onto the court. He's not a substitute, he's an addition. Now there are 13 people on this court. Three refs, 10 players, five from each team. There's a whistle of some sort. Okay, another interesting fact about basketball. Basketball did not become an Olympic event until the 1936 games in the summer in Berlin, Germany. So the Olympics, all the way from before Christ, had not had basketball in it until 1936.
Watch out, watch out.
It's the grace of holy orders right here.
By Canadian? Nice. And we just heard from my assistant that the game of basketball was invented by a Canadian. Who would have thought, all these years later, playing basketball here in America, two countries, fused together by the common game of basketball. Shoots? Oh, close miss. Bruté with the rebound. It's a 5-point game here in Mundelein, Illinois. Pass, shot, score! Bishop Simon Bruté coming out hot here in the second half. Shot, score. Widen the gap again to five. Our Lady Guadalupe here in the lead. 17-12 with about 12 and a half minutes left to go. Subs come in, players come out, rest themselves, hopefully recuperate for the next game of play. All right, Our Lady Guadalupe here on the offensive. He's dribbling. Some whistle of some sort. Simon Bruté's ball. They dribble down the court. Passes. Looks. Passes. Out of bounds.
Sub
comes in for Our Lady Guadalupe. Our Lady Guadalupe in the white, Bishop Time Bruté in the blue. This is a fight for third place. This is a fight for consolation, a fight to avoid desolation. Simon Bruté on the offensive. They pass the orange ball back to each other. Alright, a little timeout from blue. At this point, we want to give a little shout out to all you Our Lady of Guadalupe fans, all you Simon Bruté fans. Pray for your respective teams. Intercess for the Lord. They're having fun out here, but it is an intense game. Pray for them that they stay hydrated. Pray for them that they have safe. Pray for them that they have fun. But pray for them that they become holy priests. All of these men you see here on the court, some of the people in the audience, are all and have one common goal: to grow in holiness by being invited to the priesthood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Pray for them. Pray for anybody you might know who might have a vocation. Pray for all vocations, marriage, religious life, and priesthood. And pray for each other on this beautiful Sunday we have here in Mundelein at the Father Pat O'Malley Invitational. Athleta Christi Nobilis, noble athlete of Christ. Amen. Alleluia. Shots underway, short. Rebound in Bruté. Score, 2 points, Our Lady Guadalupe. So last half we learned the interesting fact that Bishop Simon Bruté was a French missionary to America. Did a lot of good things, and people absolutely venerated him. And so they named a seminary after him, and his cause is underway. Bishop Simon Bruté. Interesting facts about Our Lady of Guadalupe. It's a Marian apparition that took place in the 1500s in Mexico. Mothers always know best. She told Juan Diego to build a chapel. Now a basilica is built there, and millions of people from all around the world go to venerate Our Lady of Guadalupe. A little shout out to Chip Chipman, seminarian for the Diocese of Peoria, Illinois.
Chip!
Chip, we miss you, man.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do. You're the man, Chip. Stay awesome, okay? On the floor. The intensity of this crowd is amazing. the intensity of these players as the desire just perspirates from them. Isaac has to clean it up. Nothing swept under the rug here. All is on the court for third place. 17-21 here, under 8 minutes left to go here in the last and final half. Again, want to reiterate, the team with the most points at the end of the game is the winner. Dribbling, shooting, missing, rebounding, shooting, scoring! We have ourselves a game here, 21-19. Our Lady of Guadalupe Seminary in the lead by two as they approach down the floor on the offensive. Shoots, rebounds, out of bounds on blue. White ball. Drives, shoots, layups, misses. Rebound blue. Simon Bruté advances down the court, looking to tie the game. Will this be the equalizer?
Timeout
White. Our Lady of Guadalupe looks to sub in their entire team. Will this strategy pay off? Time will tell. Also want to give a little shout out to Cassie Pease over there in the pink with her sister. She's one of my favorite Catholic celebrities. Go check out her website. Awesome prints, awesome art that she does. You can put it on your iPhone, you can put it on your laptop, you can put it on your computer. Wonderful images help you to pray a little bit, get deeper with the Lord. And let's just check out some of these images right here. Look how beautiful that is. Wonderful. So go check out our website, cassiepease.com. There are many other celebrities today. For example, Father Karchi is over there. He's our rector here at Mundelein Seminary. He's the boss. He basically determines and makes sure that we are approaching formation correctly, that we are being formed into good, holy men, and eventually good, holy priests. As I said, lots of celebrities. A little confusion as we switch sides yet again. 6.5 minutes left to go here in the final half. Shoots. Misses, rebounds, Our Lady of Guadalupe, passes, and they drive down the court, dribbling, 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 dribbling. Passing, waiting, waiting, passing, waiting, waiting, dribbling, dribbling, shooting. Wow! They extend their lead by four. Our Lady of Guadalupe, 23, Bruté, 19. Under 6 minutes left to go here in the final half. I just won one here, under 5 minutes left to go in the last and final half. Bruté on the offensive, shoots. Wow! Swiss! 25-24 here, 4 minutes left to go in the final half. Bruté driving, shooting, missing. With under 3 minutes left to go here in the final half. We have ourselves a game here, folks. The crowd is on its feet. The intensity is high. People want it. No desolation. No last place. It's third place, and for consolation, all the marbles in the bag. Guadalupe looking to take the lead. No, not on Bruté's watch. Not on Bruté's watch. The teams are tired. Will they give their last effort for these last 2 minutes? This is for all the marbles. And a foul occurs on the play. 1.5 minutes left to go here, and the game is tied at 27. He might get a couple shots, he might not. I'm not sure exactly how it works. And a score! Ole Guadalupe up by 2 with 1.5 minutes left to go here in the last half. Looking to answer. Will this be the equalizer? On the ground. Good friend. Passing. Timeout, Blue. I do not know if YouTube does it justice. The intensity in this gym right now is flying. People wanting to walk away with this trophy. People wanting to walk away with consolation. People wanting to walk away with them the prize of victory, the prize of third place. 1:03 left to go here, which will decide who will be the victor. Thank you. The countdown has started. It is the final countdown. Doo-doo-doo-doo. The final countdown. Here we go. White ball. Blue ball. Just kidding. JK, LOL. 51 seconds left to play here. The intensity of this game is unparalleled. Folks, these teams have been playing all weekend. They are tired, they are exhausted, but within their heart is a desire for victory. Who will come out on top? Now is not the time to get ice cream. She shoots, it's away. Oh, so close. Takes the ball, shoots it. Oh, so close. 35 seconds left to play here. Our Lady Guadalupe ball, they pass. Driving down the court. Our Lady Guadalupe trying to play keep away. 20 seconds left to play. He passes it, throws it, dribbles it, passes it. Foul! 13.7 seconds left to play here. And Our Lady Guadalupe will get two shots. Just kidding, they'll take it out of bounds. The crowd is on its feet. The intensity is high. Another foul. 11 seconds left to go. Take the ball out of bounds. Bruté looking for some magic. Passing the ball. One second left to play. All right, he will take himself a couple shots. Looking to widen the lead just in case any last minute magic happens from Bruté. Ladies and gentlemen, a close game between two very tired yet desiring teams. Our Lady Guadalupe on top, 29-27. They take with them the prize of consolation. Well, Simon Bruté played a tough match, very scrappy, very good group of young men, all in formation for priesthood. Pray for them. We want to thank the Knights of Columbus again for being our sponsor. We want to praise and thank the Lord Jesus for being our ultimate sponsor. And Father Cartier right now to award the third place trophy after the teams gather together in a prayer to thank the Lord for this wonderful time of fraternity, fun, and basketball. Jack Knight, everybody, from the Great Diocese of Atlanta. You might wonder, what are so many Atlantans doing up here in the north? Well, that's a wonderful question. We're sent up here because most of us are studying. Jack studies at a different seminary. He's a stand-up guy. And here we have the Mundelein Lakers, who are getting ready to go sit on their bench. Wave, Lakers. Thank you, Garrett. Garrett is going with a new style of tape on the side of his eye. It's a cool thing to do nowadays. Here we go. This is a third place trophy thing. Our Lady Guadalupe.
I love Cassie P's. Show the image of your phone. Unbelievable, man.
You gotta give people a shout out, you know?
It's been so fun. Yeah, well done. I didn't realize the identity crisis that basketball's having. It should be really called hoopball.
It's a question, right? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have 12 and a half minutes left to go here before this pause, before this game starts. We have the Mundelein Lakers, and we have the St. Vincent de Paul DePaulians. I'm not sure what they are, but they're set to set off to determine number one and number two of the 2018 Father Pat O'Malley Invitational. Time will tell who wins, points will tell who wins. Grit, determination, intensity, desire will tell who wins. One game of basketball, one first place victor, one second place victor, one immortal prize of victory. Stay tuned for more to come. I got a few texts from Tim, man. He's good, man. Yeah.
Absolutely. It's exciting. It was my second theology year that we got together. Exciting. Wouldn't it be awesome? We have this gym. Guys are always out here playing. Just to get together some of the teams from area seminaries. Father Dennis Spies, who's on our faculty now, was one of the primary organizers of the tournament. And back in the day, I don't remember the exact number, but it was pretty much an afternoon event. You know, you get six teams or so, but it just grew year after year. To see what it's become now, I can't tell you how exciting it is for me. And I just want to give a huge shout out to the Knights of Columbus, because they really are the ones who've made this possible, you know, as you well know. But it does just keep growing. I definitely want to see the Lakers at the final, yep, as they often are. But we got some great guys here today. It's also exciting to see a college team again, Bruté, in the Final Four.
Yeah.
So they showed themselves up pretty well. A lot of times the population of those schools is smaller the major seminaries. So I know it's a bit of a civil war for Atlanta.
A little bit.
Guys on both sides, but you know, I know you know where your allegiance is.
Exactly.
So the North needs to win this one. All right, sure. Jacob Michael.
All right, thank
so
you, Father Karchi. Thank you for that wonderful history. So Father Karchi mentioned that this game, this tournament has been going on since the second year of theology. That was back in 1920. 98 years. But it's true. Every single year, there's been more and more teams been coming to this event. This year, we had 16 teams come from across the country, all the way from Oregon, all the way down to Florida, and everything in between. And it's a wonderful event, as I can say myself as a seminarian, having come to this event 5 times, that seminaries from all over the country, all towards one goal of becoming good men, holy men, and priesthood. And to be united here in this game of basketball with a little bit of friendly competition going on, it's very healthy for us and it's a great event just to be out here and with our brothers. Again, we have 9 minutes left to go here before the tip-off. Stay tuned, buckle up your seatbelts, strap on your shoes. It's going to be a good one.
I need to get ESPN out here.
Right? Roasting also to EWTN for them to do like a live streaming of something. Yeah. Show up on ESPN 2 or something like that. That'd be good.
If that happens, better than Australian rules.
Seriously. People would be intrigued. I think seeing a bunch of people starting to become priests playing basketball with each other, yeah. We'll have to get, I think John Viennese said he, right? John Washington?
Yeah.
We'll have to get him to contact the ESPN, yeah.
I did. Do you ever watch Around the Horn?
Yeah.
I did the marriage prep for the host. I already forgot his name. Because I was in D.C. He's a real captain. He's a master. Time for some introductions and things. These are our referees for the game. Their respective teams go to their respective benches. Mundelein here in the West, same as DePaul here in the East.
I was communicating with Mundelein wins this game. I'm not seeing your troops will send out a case of fresh Florida oranges.
Ew, you're on camera.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and open your hats for the play of our national anthem.
It's all basketball here, folks. And you heard Father Rector. First place on the line, second place on the line, a case of Lou Malnati's pizza on the line, oranges on the line. There is a lot on the line here. All the marbles in the bag until they have to come next year. Now you're listening to your starting lineup. For the St. Vincent de Paul DePaulians. Tip-off is underway. 13 people on the court. 3 refs, 5 people from St. Vincent de Paul, 5 people from Mundelein. Tip-off is about to begin. There are 2 halves, 18 minutes each. Clock does stop. The team with the most amount of points at the end of the game, they will be the winners. Same as in Paul's ball, but we are underway. People strap in, buckle up, get your shoes on. This is going to be a game for the ages. Two very evenly matched teams. Two very competitive teams. Two very intense teams. Two teams that won it badly. This is all for the championship. Now it's St. Vincent de Paul's turn to try and make something happen. It's a ref whistle of some sort. 17 minutes left to play here. So close, yet so far. Ball in. The crowd is on its feet as they cheer on their defense. Mundelein, of course, with a home field advantage. St. Vincent de Paul all the way from Florida. Ref whistle, that was on Joe Wagner. So Mundelein does enjoy the home field advantage, but don't let that fool you. Both teams want it bad. And you cannot underestimate a team that wants it bad. Into the Paul's ball as they look toward to extend their lead. Thank you.
Wow.
6-0. St. Vincent de Paul.
And they're off to a lead quickly.
That's a bucket for two.
And one or two shots for him. Number 44, Theo McManigal is coming in. Interesting fact about Theo. His name is Theo, which is Greek for God. He is not God, however. He is a human. 4-6, Mundelein. Mundelein recovers the ball. Theo with a close basket. Or two for his free throw. You can hear a pin drop right now. And it's good. Same as in the Paul up 6, 9-3. Here in the first of two halves. Those of you just joining us, this is it. This is for all the marbles. This is the championship of the Seminary Universe. The winner of this game will either get a crate of oranges or a case of Lou Malnati's pizza, and they will be able to call themselves the victors of the 2018 Father Pat O'Malley Invitational. Sorry, that was the score. St. Vincent de Paul up 10, here with 12 minutes left to go. About to resume here. 12 minutes left to go in the first of two halves. Guys are okay. St. Vincent de Paul up 7 here on offense. Moving the ball down the court. Dribbling, 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 shooting, scoring! Pat Lamar from the Archdiocese of Atlanta. Time for your faithfully fantastic, fun, faithful trivia. The St. Vincent de Paul Regional Seminary hails from Boynton Beach, about an hour north of Miami. Shout out to all you people supporting St. Vincent de Paul. St. Vincent de Paul himself was a French Roman Catholic priest who lived in the late 16th to early 17th century. He was really renowned for his work with the poor and did a lot to serve them. If you visit the Church of the Miraculous Medal in Paris, France, you're actually able to see his heart. They say people who have served have a heart of gold. In this case, it might literally be true. St. Vincent de Paul. Time to resume play here in the championship game here at the 2018 Father Pat O'Malley Tournament. Mundelein Lakers against Our Lady of Guadalupe, St. Vincent Paul Seminary. A little scuffle. Willie checks in for the Lakers. Offensive magic to happen. Tense game going on right here. 14-28. 4 minutes left to go here in the first half. Objective is to score points by placing the ball in the opponent's basket. The basket is kept at a height of 10 feet. That's 10 feet. The team will talk strategy here as White takes a timeout. Another fun fact, the first basketball game was held on January 20th of 1892.
They ran a lot less than they used to. The court was half the size of the courts used in the NBA league today. There were 9 players in each team. And we have the great Diocese of Davenport sweeping up our floors. Thank you, Diocese of Davenport, for your 2 wonderful seminarians volunteering for our table. Also want to give a shout out to the Archdiocese of Atlanta and the Diocese of Yakima for giving to us some free theologians to help us out in our game of basketball here today. The score is 14-31. Interesting fact about him, he is made of pure muscle. No bone, no organs, pure muscle. You can see the definition, especially in his deltoids. Here he takes 2 shots. Or 1, I don't know. And he makes his first. And 2 subs come in. So the strategy with the sub is basically the players are out there running around, running back and forth, running east-west, running up and down the court, and they get tired of running so much. Huh, surprise. But the fact of the matter is, somebody has to step in to them once they get super tired. And that's the point of the sub. The player gets tired, the sub comes in. To 34 here as Theo gets 1 or 2 shots. Free throws, ladies and gentlemen, they don't cost a thing.
Thank you.
Timmons and Paul dribbles down the court. Dribbling, dribbling, dribbling. Shooting, scoring. Wagner's flying around out there, folks. A shout out to Joe Wagner's family. They are some of the most wonderful people that you will ever meet. Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Wagner. Thank you for your son. He's awesome. Here we go. He gets one or two shots. There we go. That's Anthony Astreb. For those of you who don't know, shout out to all you St. Vincent de Paul St. Vincent de Paul fans out there. Yeah. 40 seconds left to go here in the first half. Mundelein is down by 14 as they steal the ball. Here we go, 30 seconds left. Can Mundelein chip away at this lead to go into the first half with some momentum for them in the second? Theo passes the ball. Timmons ball steals it. There's 20 seconds left in the half. St. Vincent ball driving down the court. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. Waiting for it. Waiting for the right moment. 3, 2, 1. Sliding around on the ground, there's no telling what these people will do for points. 1 second left. That's your halftime score, folks. 25-42. This is a lot harder than it looks. A regulation size basketball is 9.55 inches in diameter. A regulation size hoop is 18 inches in diameter. Not only to mention, he's wearing a mascot hat. It is incredibly tough to see through that thing. Thank you. request to allow the intercession of Mary to commend to these players that they may grow in fraternity, that they may grow in faith, that they may grow in friendship, that they may grow in fun, to have joy as they play this last game, last half of basketball. Mary, we entrust these people to your care. Keep them safe. Help them have fun. Help them grow into holy men and eventually become holy priests. Amen. Fact about basketball, early basketball hoops were nailed to the mezzanine balcony of the court. After spectators in the balcony continually interfered with shots, the backboard was invented. A little interesting fact about basketball. Its little known nickname is called the East-West Game. Due to the sub-relegated microeconomic housing system of the mid to late 19th century, houses were placed on streets with the majority of it going east-west. Therefore, a lot of the basketball courts do in fact go east-west. Players do run up and down the court pretty frequently, thus winning the name the East-West Game. Left here in this halftime break as the teams are strategizing, warming up, getting ready for this last half. This is the final half. There are only two halves in the game of basketball. The first and then the second. And for those of you just tuning in, this is for the championship. This is for the 2018 Father Pat O'Malley Invitational Championship. The winner of this game gets first place. The loser of this game gets second place. There's also a bet placed on the two rectors of each seminary. If Mundelein wins, St. Vincent de Paul will send up a crate of oranges. If St. Vincent de Paul wins, Mundelein will send down to them a case of Lou Malnati's pizza. Can't beat that. All right, let the second half begin. The crowd is on its feet. The intensity is present. People are perspirating the intensity, the desire to win. There is no telling what these people will do for points, and they will do a lot. Mundelein is down by 17, 25-42, St. Vincent de Paul, here in the second half. 18 minutes left to go. 18 minutes for the destiny of the 2018 trophy. Michael Metz with the ball. There you go, St. Vincent ball on the rebound. No good. Mundelein ball. As they pass, dribble, 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 dribble. Next time, Theo, next time. Back down the court, back down this way. Go, 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 go. feet, doing some weird chant, hoping to distract the St. Vincent de Paulians. Pat Lamar from the Archdiocese of Atlanta with a bucket for two. Mike Metz with the ball. A little shout out to the Metz family. They're a wonderful family. Mike Metz, his number 35, is to symbolize how many brothers and sisters he has. He is one of 35. Haha, just kidding. He is one of 11. He has a wonderful family, wonderful siblings. Shout out to you, the Metzes. Hope y'all are doing well. Looking forward to hanging out with y'all sometime. So close. I'm telling you folks, it's not easy to get the ball inside one of these hoops. You're already dealing with the fact that a regulation size hoop is 18 inches in diameter. A ball itself is about 9.5 inches in diameter. On top of that, you throw five angry people just trying to come after you, and that ball is incredibly hard to get inside the hoop. There you go. Mundelein 25, St. Vincent de Paul 46, here in the second half. Theo with a three. Sweet. Thank you for keeping it clean. Just want to give a little shout out to the Holy Land guys. Mundelein in our curriculum here. Most of the men from the third year of Mundelein Seminary go to the Holy Land. A little shout out to our brothers over there who are currently in their 3 of 9 weeks over there. Want to give a little shout out to them. Hopefully they can intercess for the Mundelein team as they need a little bit of help. We miss y'all. The Muscle Lions checks in for Theo. Folks, these players are tired. They've been playing high-intensity games over the course of this weekend. But you can't underestimate a man's desire to win. And that is exactly what we are seeing before us right now. The desire to win. Travel. Vincent DePaul with the timeout. I want to give a special shout out to our sponsors, the Knights of Columbus, who do wonderful things in our church and wonderful things in our community, wonderful things for seminarians. We want to give a shout out to our sponsor, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, indeed. A fan says to score more often. The team that scores the most will win. Set to play. Under 14 minutes left to go here in the second half. Interesting basketball fact. A warm basketball is bouncier than a cold one because the molecules in the warm ball hits the inside surface at a higher speed. fun fact of basketball. Shout out to his family. They are wonderful people too, but they are not on YouTube. They're in fact over there in the stands cheering on their son. Go Elliot Zach. Go Zach family. Elliot Zach with the three. From our viewer, basketball was invented by James Naismith. Anyways, before I was rudely interrupted, I was just saying that basketball was invented by James Naismith, who coached at KU. Tomorrow is Kansas Day. A shout out to all you Kansans out there. Happy Kansas Day tomorrow. God bless. Garrett Burns from Kansas. Tomorrow is Kansas Day. Oh yeah, Viet's also from Kansas. Hey Viet. Here we go, he's gonna shoot one or two. Huh? He's gonna shoot two. Here we go, his second attempt. Wave your spirit fingers, everybody. There we go. 34-46. Under 12 minutes to play left here in the second half. Interesting fact, before 1923, basketball teams could choose a player which would shoot the free throw after a foul, rather than the player who was fouled. Comment below who you think should be shooting free throws for both teams. Joe with a three. Oh, so close. Rebound, Timmins and DePaul. Timmins and DePaul driving down the court. A little steal attempt by Garrett Burns. The crowd is on its feet. For three. No good. Rebound, Mundelein. A little scuffle. But they're good. Let the boys play. Under 10 to go. Mike Metz at the three. No good. Dribbling, driving, passing, fouling. Just kidding, out of bounds. First checking in for Garrett. A Kansan for a Kansan. I want to give a little shout out to all the parents of the players who are watching. Shout out to you. Thank you for your sons. Thank you for allowing them to become priests. Thank you for your support.
I'm a seven.
Left to go here in the final half. This is for all the marbles. This is for the championship. This is for the pride, the glory of the Father Pat O'Malley Invitational. Rebounding. St. Vincent de Paul's ball. As they try to move the ball down the court, they are moving east right now. Moving east in the great east-west game. Cannot do it justice. These players are flying around the court. The average NBA player runs 4 miles a game. The seminarians, 6, 7, 8 miles during the game. About 7 minutes left here to play. Score is still 34-50. Folks, you know what they say. One man can be a crucial ingredient on a team, but one man cannot make a team. The teamwork these teams are displaying are crucial, essential, very inherent to the necessity of making a great team awesome. Elliott's back with the rebound. It's a fast break. Take up one or two shots here. They say that the recommended air pressure for most basketballs is between 7 and 9 pounds per square inch. That's PSI. The NBA requires the game balls to be inflated between 7.3 and 8.5. Rest assured that we have properly inflated the balls here at Mundelein. Cut to 12. Mundelein on the offensive. Mundelein with momentum. Five and a half minutes left to play, 38-50. Wow, cutting between the defense. Maybe Tolman for two. In 2010, NBA uniforms were 30% lighter than in past years and dried twice as fast as previous ones. Timeout on the white. 5:11 left to go here in the last and final half. 38-52, this is a game for the centuries.
Give it up once again for Mundelein.
Thank you.
players have rested, the players have hydrated, the players have strategized. It is time to take on these last 5 minutes, 11 seconds. For all the marbles in the bag. Oh, here we go. This is the prize. The immortal prize of victory right here, carried by 2 of Atlanta's finest. Look at those trophies, people. Just look at those trophies. Wow. Those are worth fighting for. Minutes left to play here. Elliott Zach with another foul. Now we're shooting for points. Pat Lamar with a free throw. One of Atlanta's finest. He's from Georgia Tech, but we'll forgive him for that. Nick too. What? I'm in control of the camera here. Man. Gosh. YouTube does not do this justice. The intensity with which these men are playing is incredible. Elliott, the slider, Zach. JP Coleman with 2 points. Oh gosh. Just kidding, with one shot. Left to go here in this last half of the Father Pat O'Malley Seminary Tournament. Here with 3. Too close. Too close for comfort. Joe with 3. Ah. Are these hoops regulation size, ref? Offensive magic. Pat Willey with 3. Oh, no go. Same as the ball with the rebound. 18 points to go for Mundelein to tie it up. Can they equalize? Foul on Pat Willey. I want to give a shout out to Pat Willey's family. they're over there, proud parents of Pat Willing, first pre-theology from Chicago, seminarian here at Mundelein. We thank them for their son, Pat. And that's another point. Yeah, Arturo Merriman checks in for St. Vincent de Paul. He's an Atlanta seminarian, and therefore a stand-up guy. JP with the second attempt. Alec the Muscle Lions looks to check in. Seriously, folks, he is literally made of one big muscle. Like, seriously, this dude is so jacked. Look at that. That's amazing. Theo with three. No good. Less than 2 minutes left to go. Alec Lyons with the rebound, with the putback. JP Coleman with the steal, with the pass. Troy waiting, 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 passing, waiting. Passing, waiting, dribbling. Pat Willie will not go down without a fight. Waiting, 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 passing. All right, timeout blue. We just want to give a shout out to God, who without him, none of this could be possible. It is by his will and his desire that you exist. Praise be to the Lord. Amen. By himself to take some shots. If you've ever wondered how many pebbles or bumps there are per inch on a Spalding basketball, rest assured that there are 122 bumps per square inch on a basketball. That's one of your amazing basketball facts of the day. Wow. Pat Willie. Fact about Cardinal Mundelein, unlike St. Vincent de Paul, he is not yet a saint. He is, however, buried here in Mundelein. So if you're looking for a miracle, why not ask for that miracle through his intercession, get him canonized, and get you healed. Pray for us, Mundelein. 50 seconds left to go here. Mundelein down by 9 or 19. It is too intense to count here. They're passing, trying to take up as much time as possible. And they're called for offsides. Mundelein ball. In the remaining 38 seconds, can they score 38 points to take the lead and the victory? This is for all the pride. This is for all the marbles. This is for the championship, for the glory. Theo for three. Oh, it's no good. St. Vincent de Paul, out on them. 30 seconds left to go. 39-58. 19 points is 7 3-pointers. Can Mundelein do it? Theo, to give it a try. Pat Willie, the three. Yes! 19, 18, 17. Pat Willie with the steal. the magic happen. Six more three-pointers to go. 14 seconds left. Never lose hope. Seconds to go. Pat Willie with some more free throws. A pin could be heard dropping. And he makes it. One more for Pat Willie. Now we're looking at 5 three-pointers. Can they do it? 12 seconds left to go. Time will tell. Final score, Mundelein 44, Simmons and Paul 58. Knights of Columbus, Jesus. Come on, folks, we're moving here. Vincent DePaul, MVP. Oh, just kidding, he's the MVP. Folks. Second place, Mundelein Lakers. Champions, the 2018 champions, St. Vincent de Paul Seminary, Boynton Beach, Florida. It's been a pleasure, everybody. Hope you had a good time watching this basketball game. Pray for these seminarians. Pray for their formators. Pray that we may become good, holy men, holy priests, as we approach whatever our ordination is, and as we do God's will. Amen.
And Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together in fellowship, renewing, reigniting the vocational journey you call us to. We ask again your blessing upon all of our seminaries, seminarians represented here, and the people you entrust to our care this day and in the years to come. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. There you have it, folks. The 2018 Father Pat O'Malley Invitational. This is your host, signing off. God bless.